the phenomena of crystalline hydrate having two different solubilities at the same temperature is called retroflux solubility. It is the specialty of crystalline hydrates. Okay. Then BCD is the solubility curve of dodecahydrate. When the point D is reached, the another crystalline hydrate, heptahydrate, starts to appear here. Therefore, DEF is the solubility curve of heptahydrate. When point F is reached, pentahydrate starts to appear. Therefore, FGH is the solubility curve of pentahydrate. When the point H is reached, the another crystalline hydrate, tetrahydrate, starts to appear. Therefore, HJ is the solubility curve of tetrahydrate. And when the point J is reached, anhydrous ferrichloride starts to appear. Therefore, JK is the solubility curve of anhydrous ferrichloride. Along all these curves, there are two phases exist in equilibrium. Here, ice and solution. Here, along the curve BCD, dodecahydrate and its solution. Along the curve DEF, heptahydrate and its solution. Along the curve FGH, pentahydrate and its solution. Along the curve HJ, tetrahydrate and its solution exists in equilibrium. So therefore, along all these curves, when we use reduced phase rule equation, we have that is equal to C minus P plus 1 equal to, in the two component system, two phases exist in equilibrium, which is equal to 1. Therefore, all these curves are monovariant. All these curves are monovariant. Now let us go to next point, congruent points. What is actually congruent point? In the last class we have studied, congruent point is the point at which the solid salt and its milk will have identical composition. Okay, therefore here we have four different congruent points. They have four different congruent melting points. Okay, what are the congruent melting points? Okay, different compounds will have different congruent melting points. That is, congruent points, congruent melting points in degree centigrade and hydrates. They have congruent points CEGI. Point C will occur at a temperature 37 degrees centigrade. Point D at 32.5 degrees centigrade. Point G occurs at 56 degrees centigrade. And point I 73.5 degree centigrade. Okay, this 37.5 degree centigrade of dodecahydrate, it is of heptahydrate salt, it is of pentahydrate salt, this is for tetrahydrate salt. Point I for tetrahydrate. Okay. These are all the melting points of the corresponding hydrated salts. Okay. At these points, the compound, that is the salt and its melt, will have identical composition. In this point, there exists as a single component. When it forms a crystalline hydrate, there forms a single component. Therefore, to find out the number of degrees of freedom, again, I am using reduced phase rule equation. F dash is equal to C minus P plus 1 equal to, here it is not a two component system, one component system having two phases. Because solid and its melt plus one, therefore it will be equal to zero. Therefore, all the congruent points are non-variant or invariant. Okay. Next we are going to find dependent points. See, this phase diagram and this ferric chloride water system made up of five simple eutectic systems. This is one simple eutectic system, this is one, and this is one. It is made up of several simple eutectic systems. That is why it is called composite system. It is also called composite system. See, the eutectic points we have B, D, F, and H. B, D, F, H, and J. Now, see, at this point B, in all the congruent points, there are three phases existing in India. They will occur at different temperatures, at different congruent melting, that is, at different eutectic points. Okay? They will have three phases. It is definition as follows. See, eutectic points. In a eutectic point, that is B, E, F, H, and J. They have eutectic temperatures. The eutectic temperature of E, that is eutectic points. B at minus 55 degrees centigrade, D at 27.4 degrees centigrade, F at 30 degrees centigrade, H at 55 degrees centigrade, and J at 66 degrees centigrade. Okay. At this point B, there are three phases exist in equilibrium, that is ice, dodecahydrate and solution. There are three phases. The phases will be ice%, dodecahydrate and solution. See, note at this point D. Here D also there are three phases. Dodecahydrate, heptahydrate and solution. Dodecahydrate, heptahydrate and solution. At a point F, heptahydrate, pentahydrate and solution will be there. So therefore, heptahydrate, pentahydrate and solution. At a point H, see, at a point H, pentahydrate, tetrahydrate and solution. Pentahydrate, tetrahydrate and solution. The last eutectic point J at 66 degrees centigrade will be, that is, pentahydrate, tetrahydrate and solution. The last point J, tetrahydrate, anhydrous ferric chloride and solution. That is, tetrahydrate, anhydrous ferric chloride and solution. So, eutectic point is the point where all the three phases exist in equilibrium. So, to find out the number of degrees of freedom at this point, we are using reduced phase rule equation. F dash is equal to C by S P plus 1. Two component system, there are three phases exist in equilibrium. Plus 1 will be equal to 0. Therefore, all the eutectic points are non-variant. That shows that both temperature and composition is fixed. Okay? And the region here, it contains only liquid form. Solution. Okay? Solution will be there. Here in this region, only ice will be there. So all these things you have to explain.
for ethylene chloride water system, it may be asked in 5 mark question or sometimes it may be asked in 10 mark question.